Good morning, good afternoon, depending on your location. Hello and a warm welcome to all participants of this WITOR webinar. Today we want to speak about the gearless drives from WITOR, but at first I want to introduce WITOR. Who we are, WITOR is one of the world's leading provider of components, module systems, and modules and systems for the elevator industry, with a revenue of more than 800 million euro in 2019. We have worldwide located in more than 15 countries with more than 4,800 employees. And we have 16 production sites and 7 competence centers. Next one. WITOR has a huge portfolio of products. The main components are the doors, but we have competences in safety components, in cars, and in gearless drives too. Next. WITOR have a global footprint. That means we are located in different countries with production locations, and the gearless drives were produced in Germany, in Dresden, in Eastern Germany. The company was established in 1984 in the former GDR. We have a long history for electrical machines. We are since 1999 member of the WITOR Group, responsible for the gearless elevator drives, and we are the competence center for the drives in the WITOR Group. Next. We have a huge product portfolio on different elevator gearless machines with which we catch a lot of elevator applications. The features of our gearless machines are, as our motors are especially for steel and PU coated ropes designed. The machines are suitable for machine room less application and machine room application in suspension 2-to-1 and 1-to-1 or others. The machine's suitable for rope tension in all directions. This is one USP of our motor design. We have designed compact machines for reduced headroom or pitch. And we use the modular system, which allows to use a lot of options for each motor type. The machines are designed under the assumption of extreme low noise, low vibrations, high efficiency, and the machines are nearly maintenance free. Next one. Can you go one back, please? What I add here is that the values which you can see here are shown the application data for suspension 2-to-1, but of course it's possible to use the machine in 1-to-1 too. Thanks, next one. The smallest machine of our product portfolio is called WSGRF. This machine is a new motor series designed for systems with rated loads up to 10,050 kg. The special traction shifter of 120 mm is in special for solutions with PU coated ropes. Here we use a special power connection via plug. It's very easy installation on job site, and the same for the installation on the brake. A new brake generation has the option of inductive switch. With a maximum width of 210 millimeter, the machine is suitable for limited spaces in the headroom, and with a weight of 130 kilograms, very easy to handle. Next one. Our motor series WSGSF and MF are established since 2 years on the market. These machines replaced the former old series of WSGS1 and S2. Here we have a standard delivery time of 20 working days for the standard machines or standard specifications, but we have a high number of the possibility of a high number of different traction sheaves with which we can make customized solutions. That means, for example, these machines are possible for replacement of existing gearbox installations with a big traction sheave. These machines too all have the rope tension in all directions. And with loads from 320 kilogram up to 1,800 kilogram, we met requirements for the typical residential applications or smaller healthcare lifts. All machines are suitable for MIL solutions. Next one. Our WSGLF is the biggest motor size of our servo gearless row. With this loads from 1,050 kg up to 3,000 kg, we met the first requirements of intensive use lifts or healthy care lifts and for goods lifts. This motor is the first one which is suitable for installations with 60 millimeter ropes. And there is, we catch existing older installations of elevators. And the machine is suitable for single web, and the first one which is suitable for double web solutions. Next one. Vitro has an own solution for inverters in the product portfolio. Therefore, we have started a relationship with Danfoss as one of the biggest inverter companies worldwide. We have installed or create a special package which can realize a very easy handling on job site, a very easy plug solution. This inverter includes all our motor data, and you find on the machine itself a drive code, and this makes it very easy to start this system. As additional, we designed or we have developed a condition monitoring system. And that means we used with a WED IoT box, we can transmit data to a cloud or to a dashboard, and this can be sent directly to the operator. That means we are able, or that is possible, a monitoring of drive cycles, of number of rise, operating hours, vibrations. It's possible too to see the maintenance or to give information of coming maintenance. It's possible to see the position of the car on the shaft. You can see or can make a history of load and motor torque, or you can see the existing load and motor torques of the application. It's possible to see the rides per hour, and it's possible too to make an energy consumption. The requirement conditions on the shaft are very easy. Only required is an Ethernet or Wi-Fi installation and space for the WED IoT box. Next one. Because on the market, existing market, and special for modernization projects, we have designed in 2017 a belt solution or a machine where we can use belts. We started with a special belt with profiled on one or both sides. With this belt, we can realize very small distances between the belts, but because of the new requirements, new situation on the market, we have a new product which is suitable for flat belts. With these solutions, we catch small solutions of the Otis Gen 2 as example. But this machine is usable too for new installations, for new elevator designs too. Next one, please. With our WSG2125, we start the machine series which is called Beamer. These machines are the machines for typical mid-rise, high-rise, and heavy load applications. Here we speak about loads from 1,600 kg up to 4,000 kg, and possible sheaf shaft load of 140 up to 200 kilonewton. And possible two for these machines are speeds up to 10 meters per second in one-to-one suspension. That means we catch the first or smaller high-rise applications. Special for these machines are a high number of different traction sheaves are available. That means we started with 530 millimeter up to 686 millimeter or bigger. Here we are very flexible. And we have two the option to have a variable number of brakes and the possibility to use adapted or adjusted brake torque. That means we can optimize the brake of the machine at the requirements of the systems. These machines are very interesting for modernization projects because of the power torque and the design of the machine. In the next time, we are looking for a solution. How is it possible to split this housing in this is strategy project for the future? The biggest machine of this series of this design is our WSG29. This machine is here we speak a weight of 2,800 kilogram and dimensions in all directions with more than 1.5 meter. The loads are 2,700 kilogram up to 5,000 kilogram and sheaf shaft load 300 kilonewtons. And this machine is suitable tool for 10 meter per second. That is typical for high-rise applications and heavy load applications. And of course, this machine is too very interesting for modernization project. But of course, because of the dimensions and the weight of this machine, it's not so easy to handle this machine in existing installations and to bring it in a machine room, existing machine room. That was the reason for a new system, for a new design of the machine. With this machine, the technical we designed here, the WGG29, the technical values of the machine are identical to the WSG29, but this machine will be delivered in components. That means you have an easier handling of the parts because the heaviest part is 1,500 kilogram. We have a maximum width of the parts with 800 millimeter. That means we catch the typical door opening, the masses of the typical door openings. And it's an easier handling in the elevator, in the machine room without any damages on the building, for example. The assembling time of this elevator is approximately 1 up to 2 days. Here we used a special patent mounting concept for the housing and for the traction sheaf. Next one. For your better understanding, you can see here what I mean with different parts. That means we deliver an upper part of the housing, a base part of the housing. We deliver a tubular motor, traction sheaf, the traction sheaf and the accessories. The advantage of this solution is that you haven't to make any assembling on the electrical parts of the machine. That means you will get a 100% tested machine on electrical side, on the job site, and you have only installed mechanical parts. This minimizes the risk of damages during the installation of this machine, and this minimizes the risk that you install the machine at the end, you will have problems. In the next slide, you will see a short video sequence where we shown the assembling of this machine. This video sequence was done in our factory, and I will explain during this video something. The first thing of the installation is to clean up the delivered parts. That is very important for this installation, for the correct installation. Next step will be the installation of the tubular motor in the base part of the machine. We have some marks, some screws that make it which make it easier to install the machine and to bring the parts in the right position. And with this, we can, with some checks or special bolts, we can check the correct position. You will see it later. Here, that is one where we can, where you can check the right correct position of the housing. After this, the upper part will be fixed with some screws and with a special tooling. This tool can be offered too. It makes it very easy because of the wire torque. Here we speak about a new 900 Newton meter. After the fixing of this screws and the check of the correct position of all parts, we start with the installation of the traction shift. The installation of the traction shift is a very sensitive part, but it's easier because it's an easy installation because you haven't to heat up the traction shift for this. So because of this patent solution for fixing of this traction shift. The next step will be the installation of the brakes. All brakes or all components are labeled with special labels. At this you can see in which position you have to assemble these parts, and we avoid to make wrong assemblings during the installation. After the mechanical installation follows the electrical installation of the brakes, and then the check of the correct installation of the air gap of the machine. These brakes are very easy to install, and it is the check of the air gap. Finally, you have to final the last installation with which you fixed or will be ready the machine. For you to show, we have some references worldwide. Here are two pictures from installations in London Underground, Belize Park Station and Goodstead Street Station. We have other installations in France and Paris. We have installations in Tel Aviv and in Taiwan. And in the next day, we start with the installation of 8 units in Germany in Berlin. These are pictures from the machine room from Goodstead Station. The main reason of the decision to use the WGT29 was the limited access to the machine room here. Second point was the restricted space in the room because of the installation of additional equipment during the history or during the installation time of the existing machine. And that means with this solution, it was possible to realize an installation temporary of removal of items such air conditions units and other parts. This wasn't necessary of the installation. Here you can see the huge range of our machines. That means we started with typical residential lift applications up to high-rise and mid-rise lifts and heavy-duty lifts. What you can see here is our WSG52. This motor is very special for us too. That means we have dimensions more than 2 meters in all directions, and we speak about a weight of more than 8 tons. The traction shift here is 800 millimeter. That means we can use it for ropes with 20 millimeter diameter. The shaft load of this machine is 520 kilonewton and is suitable for loads up to 9,500 kilogram and speeds up to 12 meters per second. Here we have a special installation in the mine project where we have a load of 5 tons, a car of 4 tons, with a 1-to-1 installation and 4 meter speed. And we have a travel height of 480 meters in the mine, downwards in the earth. Next one. For the calculation of the elevator applications, we use our own WITIC calculation tool. This is a technical calculation tool for elevator applications. It's a very simple optical creation of the system. You can see different examples at the bottom. That means, for example, suspension 2-to-1 without the machine room, suspension 1-to-1 with machine room and with rope compensation, or such special things like suspension 6-to-1 with machine room, below beside with compensation, and others are possible. This tool includes all available machine types, all available traction shift diameters, and in special for us here in Dresden, we can add additional components which are not able or not implemented at the database yet. So for special requests, we can here do it in Dresden itself or can make calculations too. All documents of our products you will find on the official Vitor homepage. Here you can find the sales brochures, you can find technical catalogs, you find instruction handbooks, you can download the 3D files of the machines, depend on motor, on the motor type. And if not all parts here you can find, you can go in touch directly with us and we can send it special ones to you directly. What you can find here too is a link for the WITIC calculation tool where you can download the software and then you will get the information from our WITIC support how you have to install it and get the access to this.
Thank you, Jens, for your very complete presentation. I will ask now Stefan to join the floor and we can start answering the questions in the chat.
Stefan Mann is speaking. Greetings to all participants of this webinar, also from my side. Now to the questions and answers to these questions. At first, what different rope diameters can use in the MRL gearless range? Do you supply special sheave grooves? Yes, we do it. We can use ropes from 6 up to 16 millimeters in the servo gearless range. It depends on the special rope certificates from the suppliers of these ropes and also the approval in different countries. We can make special groove designs for your application. We can use V-groove hardened and also we can use semicircular grooves with and without undercut. It depends on your application. This all we can also calculate with our WITIC tool so yet that you can see the traction values and the different other things to rope pressure and so on. The customization for rope design is always possible. Adjustable bed plates for drive modernization. We have no standard solution. It is clear because every modernization has other demands, other requirements, but we can deliver bed plates for such modernizations applications. We have two partners. We work together so that we are able to deliver also bed plates for modernization. But we don't have in our company standard solutions for new installations. It is possible to get a motor with Meyer brakes? Yes, of course. Both two German suppliers of brakes, the main suppliers with Meyer and Intorx, we are using. Currently, the standard solution in the servo gearless range is Intorx brakes. But for the WSGLF, we also use Meyer brakes. for the 21 we use Meyer breaks and for the 29 we use Meyer breaks. And so we can discuss the best solution if you want to use only Meyer breaks. The drive monitoring can open. Please excuse me that I can't answer in here in all details, because this drive monitoring is also in development, because we are speaking in the Witter group for one solution, not only for own solution for the drives, so also for the solution to the doors and to the safety components. And here are we in a development process, but I think to the end of the year we can provide the solution with a lot of details in this direction. Dismantle the sheaf of WSG21 and 25. There are different situations. The 21 machine has a conical shaft end, so that it is possible to assemble the traction sheaf at shop sites, but you must have some experience also for the assembling of the brakes to this motor. But for the help, we have our support team also here in Dresden. You can come to a training to Dresden, but we can also be give some support at shop site. Especially also in the YouTube channel of Vitor, we have some videos to see how to do it. For the 25 machine, there is a cylindrical shaft, and here we have to use a heat process that is a little bit more difficult than with conical shaft end. But we are currently in a phase to think over a split housing also to the motor sizes 21 and 25. Maybe at the end of this year we can give you a detailed time schedule when we are able to deliver this both machine size also in such a design like the 29 machine. Regenerative drives, we are also able to deliver the special winding version for this drives. We are operating also with motor voltages up to 460 volts. We can deliver such modified or customized winding version so that you can always have an optimization of inverter size and can also use regenerative drives. Here we have a lot of experience also to one big customer worldwide. To use the Witter tool, yes, there are some information in at Witter website, and you can speak also with a for you responsible rating. The software we can give to the customer, and we can give also a training to the software, and you can work with this tool. For the condition monitoring, for the things to vibration and so on, please, this is in development, special things we can, how I have said, we can say at the end of the year. Gen 2 replacement, we are working at this sizes currently. We have the solution to the smaller sizes. With a flat belt, you have seen it in the presentation with a WSGTF machine. And at the end of the year, we want to start the industrialization phase to the bigger sizes to work not only with 3 belts, to work with 5 belts in these directions. No standard encoder at the servo gearless range is a Sentix encoder, but you have also the option to the Heidenhain encoder and the special interface and that of Heidenhain. At the bigger machines, the Heidenhain encoders are standard. It's just like the same question like before. Yes, we can deliver encoders with NDAT interface, but in the servo iris range to the small machines is not standard because of cost optimization. Here is our standard, the Zendix encoder. Oh, so this is a good question because we have tested our machines with different encoders and also different drives or inverters. Normally, the machines are working well, but it is a coordination of the parameters also at drive side. And sometimes we make also tests here in our factory that you can come with your drive, and so we can test also the the properties that we have with your drive and a special encoder. UCM package, there is not a solution from our side in Dresden alone. All our brakes you can use as the braking element in the UCM solution, because all brakes have the EU type examination certificate, so that you can use the brakes for uncontrolled car movement. We can also calculate this with our VITEC tool, the distances you have in the application. But for the detecting, we have to work with Austria, with Scheibs, as to use the special EOS or with a detecting device from your side. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Additional from my side, I want to add the information that for the using of WGG machines, it is possible, or we offer a training of an installation team here in Dresden on the ordered machine directly. Or the other solution is that we send our installation team to the customer directly on job site for installation of the first machine.
Thank you. I think we have time enough. Okay, another question?
The machines from the servo gearless range are maintenance free. For the Beamer 2 machines, we have re-lubrication in a special time period for the bearings that is necessary for the long lifetime of the bearings. For the servo gearless machines, we don't need any maintenance for re-lubrication and such things. But you have to check from the norm side also the brakes and so on, but it's not depend on the motor size, it depends on the norm. And for the Beamer 2 machines, you have also to respect a special installation procedure if the machine was a very long time storage or a shipment. But here we have a quick guide that is also part of the delivery of the machine. We can use, it's a new question, we can use 220 volts, yes, in the servo gearless range for the smaller machines. Here we can do a modification of the widening so that you can use also these machines with, I want to say, low power at single phase connection to the line. And this is possible also for the is possible for the WSGSF and also for the sometimes for the MF. For the LF, it is too difficult for the because of the big current in this case. Machines with ATEX, we don't have, we don't do, do any thing in this direction. The only modification we can do for you is a special solution that all machines we can deliver in IP54, but then there is for some motor types less power or less torque in the machine than in the standard machines. There was also the question to the special grease. I think it was one question before. Our standard grease is a grease with a high viscosity for a long lifetime of the bearings. And with every motor delivery, you also receive or you get a cartridge of this grease. And there is also a re-lubrication with another grease possible. This is written in the instruction manuals. And this grease are, you can get worldwide, not only here from Dresden. It's a grease that is in delivery of Kübler worldwide. Thank you. ATEX is not possible for us, I have said. And how we can choose a machine based on the duty load, we can do it, this calculations we do with VITEC, and if we have the application data, all application data with load, with car weight, with rope diameters and so on, the height of the application, we can calculate all this in our VITEC tool. And here we are also able to calculate if you want to use 180 drives per hour or 240 drives per hour. That is all possible with this VITEC tool. Yes, we deliver to most of our machines also a manual brake release. That is possible. Here we have solutions. And you can speak with our sales departments or with the ratings of Vitro for details. The Bowden cables for this manual brake release can be modified from 3 up to 8 meters. For normal standard lengths.
Thank you very much, Stefan, and thank you once again, Jens. I think we can close now. And thank you, everybody, for this really impressive session. Do not hesitate to contact a local Vitro representative for any further information or question you may have. You can find, in case, the complete list of local salespeople on Vitro website. You will receive in a few days a feedback form to help us improve this experience for our next webinars. At the end of the form, you will have the opportunity to ask for a certificate of attendance in case you want it. Further webinars will be announced soon. Stay tuned for more info. Thank you once again and have a nice day and a nice weekend. Goodbye, everybody.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.